In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform this wave propagation simulation with KiCad and the free software tool openEMS. A short description to the problem. If you inject a fast signal into a trace, the signal initially travels like a wave. So this part of the trace will be skipped initially, which will finally lead to a disturbed signal at the receiving end. Also, as the field spreads over this part of the PCB, if you have any trace placed here, it will also pick up a signal. But anyway, let's now start with the simulation process. Because I had a huge amount of problems when I installed openEMS, let's first do the installation together. If you already have openEMS installed, you can fast forward the video to the simulation chapter. Let's Google for openEMS. And now click on this link. Now download the openEMS zip file. Extract the zip file. Now copy the folder to the C drive. The steps that I show you are mostly also shown in the documentation. Once you go back to the homepage of openEMS, you can click on the documentation link. Under Install, you can scroll down to the Windows section and then click on this link. It tells us to download the Windows version of openEMS and extract it to the C drive, which we already did. The next step is to install either the Octave interface or the Python interface. As both are really useful, I will show you how to install both interfaces. For the people that don't know what Octave is, it is basically a tool that uses MATLAB scripts. Let's now first install the Python interface. For non-programmers, don't worry, we will do almost all steps with a graphical user interface. I deinstalled Python on my machine, so I can also show you how to install Python itself. Simply Google for Python. Click this link. On the Python website, scroll down until you find the Windows installer and download it. Once downloaded, start the installer. Here it is very important that you add Python to path. Now click on installation. Once the installation is finished, open the command line. Here are now two things that the documentation doesn't tell you. First, you have to install the matplotlib via this command. And also please install H5Py. Now change to the Python subfolder. I will just go to the Explorer and copy the file path from there. Now we are ready to install the two VHL files as mentioned in the documentation. I will type in pip install and copy the file name from the Explorer. You have to only install one pair of files. I will install the version 310. Once installed, let's go back to the website. The only thing left is to add openEMS to path with this command line command. Please make sure that you correctly change the folder to the one of your system. I will copy the exact link from the Explorer. We are now ready to use openEMS with Python. If you go to the Python tutorials folder, you should be able to start the Python files via double-clicking on them. If everything worked fine, you will see this message. If that's the case, wait a bit and grab a cup of coffee. If you see a screen pop up but disappear suddenly, then something is still not properly set up. In this case, you can troubleshoot the following method. Right-click on the file and open it with the application idle that was installed together with Python. If you click on Run, the next window will show you the error message. Once this tutorial file finished successfully, the bent antenna example will give you following outputs. This example shows you the S11 parameters as well as the feed point impedance. But a warning, most PCB engineers are interested in the trace impedance. Please keep in mind that this one is not the trace impedance. I will make another video on how to derive the trace impedance from a simulation. We are now done with the Python installation, so let's now install the Octave interface. For this, I will first change to the MATLAB folder of openEMS. Now let's go back to the internet browser. Let's Google for Octave and download the installer. Once the download has finished, run the installer. And after Octave is installed, go to the openEMS installation documentation for MATLAB. This part of the documentation tells you to add path to Octave. Let's do this now. Open Octave. Click on Edit and then on Set Path. Then on Add Directory. Now go to the openEMS MATLAB folder. And click on Select Folder. Now click Save and Close. Close Octave and open one of the MATLAB tutorial examples. Double clicking on one of them should open them with Octave. Run the code by pressing the Run button. You have to type in Yes here and hit Enter on your keyboard. This overrides the results of any previous simulation. After a few seconds, you should see this openEMS text appear. If that's the case, your simulation started successfully. Let's now close Octave and download the FreeCAD to openEMS tool, which is a graphical user interface that can import KiCad layouts and convert them to an openEMS simulation. Google for FreeCAD to openEMS. Click on the GitHub link. Download the code as zip file and unzip it. Now open FreeCAD. Please also use FreeCAD 0.19 in order to avoid any problems with dependencies. Switch back to the Explorer and remove the main at the end of the folder name. After that, move the macro file out of the folder. Now the macro file and the main folder have to be copied into the macro folder of FreeCAD. For this, copy both and open FreeCAD. Click on Macro and then on Macros. Click here to open the macro folder of FreeCAD and paste the folder plus the macro file here. Once pasted, click on Cancel. Close the macro window, create a new project. The macro should now be selectable in the macro menu. Click on it and click on execute. there is a bug in the software that the KiCad import button is grayed out every first time that you run the macro. Just close the window and execute the macro again. As you see here, there is a keyboard shortcut to reopen the last used macro. You can rerun the macro by typing in Ctrl plus Shift plus 1 on the keyboard. I am mentioning this as you have to rerun the macro quite often while working with the tool. Let's now click on the KiCad import button. Mark this checkmark and select the KiCad file that you want to import. The link to the files in this video are provided in the video description. Now click on import. Once finished, you will see an all done message in the report view of FreeCAD. Close the window and click on the main FreeCAD window. If you reach this point successfully, you are finally done with all installation steps and we can start the simulation process. The first thing we will do is to split the trace and the ground plane into two objects. Do this by expanding this part, now mark the two bodies, copy them, confirm the pop-up, and repaste them into the object tree. Hide the trace by clicking on it and pressing the space bar. In order to reduce the number of parts, I will create solid objects of the PCB. Do this by clicking on it and then change to the parts workbench. And then click on part. And then on convert to solid. Do this also for the trace and the ground plane. Rename the board to PCB and the ground plane to GND and the trace to trace. We will only use these three parts and delete all other parts. Once you've finished, you should end up with just three parts. Let's now add a box of air around the PCB. I make the air box 5 mm bigger than the PCB in all directions, so I can also catch the fields that travel around the PCB. I will now copy the air solid twice, and then call the new bodies E field and H field. Now reduce the height of both to 0.5 mm. Move the E field up so it's in between the trace and the ground plane. And let's place the H field slightly below the E field. Now add another rectangle at the input pad and call it port in. Open the FreeCAD to openEMS macro. And let's work through each tab. The first tab is the grid tab. Follow my steps to create the grids. What I did here is to create one coarse grid for all directions, then a slightly finer grid for the X and Y direction of the traces. Now create the materials. PEC means perfectly electric material, and I will use it for the ground plane. For the trace, I will create another metallic material and call it copper. Now let's add air. And FR4. We will excite the port with a Gaussian signal. The other signals sadly have bugs. I will make another video on how to solve the bugs with the other signals. Now create the port. choose injection in Z direction and set the amplitude to 1000. Here is a hint on how to set the field value. The direction here is important. As we apply 1 volt at the trace and 0 volts at the ground plane, we have to apply the voltage in Z direction. In the next tab, add an E-field probe and also a H-field probe. In the Simulation Params tab, change all boundaries to PML. PML means perfectly matched layer, and it tries to mimic an extension into infinity, which means that the signal can travel out of this region without any interruptions. Let's go to the first tab and assign the objects. The end result should look like this. Then select Python. Now save the settings. The settings will be stored as .ini file. And now generate the openEMS files with this button. This will create a folder with the same name as the settings file. Let's open the generated Python script, as we still have to do some manual changes to the file. As the standard time steps are quite large, I will add an oversampling of 100 to the code. This way we can see more clearly how the E-field propagates. And we also need one more change. Save the Python script and run it by double-clicking on it. If everything works correctly, the 3D model of the simulation should pop up. I will select a 2D view and make the ground layer slash pack layer invisible. Then I will also make the air layer and FR4 invisible. Once you zoom into the signal, you can check if the grid is fine enough. The grid in X and Y direction should be at least a few times finer than the trace width. Now let's change to the side view and check if the grid in Z direction is okay. The grid for the trace, the ground plane and the fields should be divided into 3 grids. Once the grid is verified, close the 3D model window. The Python window will now start showing you the simulation progress. You can now either wait for the simulation to completely finish, but once you have at least a few recorded time steps, you can already preview the simulation progress by going to the simulation folder and then type in Paraview here. Once you click on Open, you will already be redirected to the correct folder. Let's open the E-field dump, change to the electric field color, and change from the outline view to surface view. Now click this button to adjust the color range based on all time steps of the simulation and press play. I will adjust the color range so that it's more visible. We are now finished with our simulation. See you in the next video.